the video? Watch the video and do something.
Space is important because of what it tells us about ourselves. I don't feel that we know exactly what existence is and what our lives are about.
Why space? It's there. We are stardust. We're part of it. It's part of us. It's just in our species to explore, to wander, to... We want to look over that next hill.
Why space? For me, personally, ultimately, I think it's because it depends on the continuation of the human species. One thing that's very clear is if we stay on this planet indefinitely, eventually human life will come to an end.
Apollo in 1969, Shuttle in 1981, nothing in 2011. Our space program would look awesome to someone living backwards through time.
El canvi climàtic es pot entendre millor comparant el nostre planeta amb altres planetes del sistema solar on sabem que el canvi climàtic ha tingut una evolució. evolució més extremada que veiem aquí. I enviant sondes allí, que estudien aquests planetes, no és llançar els diners, sinó és invertir en coneixement que ens ajudarà a entendre millor el que passa a la Terra.
If I imagine a day without space, or without any space technologies at all, that would be a chaos.
Crec que el món de la ciència i crec com ens relacionem com a científics amb l'espai és com ens hauríem de relacionar com a humans amb el nostre entorn, no? Des de la curiositat, des de la voluntat de descobrir, d'entendre el nostre entorn.
We must stop thinking in individual and start thinking about what is best for society.
And it's all about the question, who are we, where did we came from, what is our position, what is our role in space, is there a life out of our planet?
How does space affect our daily life? How does space affect our dreams? My name is Edo Aymeric, and while I'll show you the process I followed to do this documentary, I'll be mentioning the main space spin-offs that I have used.
Space spin-offs?
What?
Yes, what are space spin-offs?
Who are you? Why are you in my documentary?
That is not important now. What are space spin-offs?
Okay. Space spin-offs, like the technologies that we get back from the research.
So, space agencies do research and development to make the missions possible.
And some of it comes back to the people in form of services, for example.
Ah, I see. Okay, continue.
Are you going to be here all the time?
It depends. But aren't you late already?
Why? Oh, I'm already having breakfast. So my phone woke me up. Phones use satellites to be able to communicate. I took a shower. There are some water purification systems in our houses that come from space.
That come from space?
Astronauts need to be able to recycle their sweat and urine to have water again. Some of these technologies of water purification can be found in our cities now.
Recycle their sweat?
Sorry, I don't have time for this. Also, NASA's metal alloys that change shape with temperature are in some showers to avoid burning your skin.
Wow, that's useful!
Please, if you stay, you stay, but let me finish, okay?
Okay.
Oh. By the way, I don't use them, but to develop some medical skin treatments and cosmetics, they use some digital imaging technology from up there.
Ah, you should use some in my opinion.
Really? Whatever. So next is cereal.
What? Cereal also comes from there?
No, cereal tastes so good.
No comments.
You know when you put it with some milk, and it's between soft and crunchy?
Edo.
Yes?
Laptops? Internet?
Oh, yes. Space missions made computers evolve towards what we have today. And internet. That's a huge topic.
Internet works with satellites, right? They use internet for everything today. News, meetings, communication, banks, research of information.
Yes, everything. Time to exercise.
Do you go to the gym?
Some of the gym equipment were designed for astronauts' workout. A lot of materials we use today are space spin-offs. Memory foams for helmets, athletic shoes evolved thanks to new materials, lightweight ultra-strength metal alloys for physician tools, tennis, bicycles.
Oh, so sports also benefit. Nice. What else?
Here I am preparing the documentary, so looking for information and...
Where do you get all this information from?
Actually, it is very easy, but don't mention it. At the NASA and ESA websites, there is a lot of information about it. A lot.
Interesting. But why don't people know?
And here I am sending emails to the contacts I wanted to interview. But you know, people are very busy.
Sarcasm?
No, real life.
Sarcasm.
I am happy with the people I got to interview, though. They are very good representatives. Do you want to meet them?
Sure. Scott Madry, Andrea Jaime, Chris Welch, Gary Martin, Marc Angelet, Joan de Dalmau. And then here I am preparing for the interviews and traveling a bit.
Oh, nice. So what about this?
What about this? It's sunny. Oh, sunny! Weather forecast. We all want to know if it's going to be a sunny weekend or not.
Sure!
And cars. Materials, sensors, GPS. How useful is this? Do you imagine how much time taxi drivers save thanks to GPS? It's amazing.
Wow, I see. What else?
Do you have a child?
Excuse me?
Well, if you have, you might use ear thermometers. Actually, health is another big field where there are a lot of benefits from space. For example, the CCD digital camera used for the Hubble telescope is used for more precise tests on women who may have breast cancer.
What? Really?
Yes. It is actually an endless list. Sunglasses, invisible braces, national security.
What do you mean, national security?
Look, space is not just spin-offs. Actually, some people say that trying to defend a program based on unintended consequences seems a poor argument.
Because you never know what you will find when you start a new research.
Well, you can direct your research and try to obtain certain results. But yes, most of the time, research and development outcomes are unintended.
Huh, I see. So when they develop something, by the way, sometimes they do such amazing things, but they're not trying to develop that thing, right?
Yes, but for example, you can't tell someone in 1900s to invent the TV, if they had no idea what a TV could be or if there was no need for one. A lot of times, there is a need and then inventions or discoveries solve it. That is science and technology. And as Sagan said, we have range of civilization in which most crucial elements profoundly depend on science and technology.
I feel like this is getting complicated.
No, wait. Space is not just spin-offs. Space can be used for security and safety, for communication, for exploration and science. Watch these interviews and see what your opinion is at the end.
Okay.
One of the reasons that space education outreach is particularly important is the nature of space projects, and that comes back to the size of the universe, the size of the solar system. The universe is a big place. It takes a long time to get anywhere, you know, really significant, and this means that many space projects have timescales of many years, in some cases many decades. This means that as we go forward and as we get more and more ambitious and want to do more and more things, our ability to run those projects over those periods becomes critically important. It means that the people who start those projects off will probably not be the people who finish them off. And so it's essential all the time to be bringing in new young people with new energy, new vision to carry those projects forward. But if you wish to have a future generation of scientists, of engineers, you need to inspire them to study the STEM subjects of science, technology, engineering, and maths.
And the picture of the Earthrise, the famous Earthrise, had more impact on people and on the planet than almost anything.
You know how we look back at the planet from the moon and you can see how fragile it is. Space was always something that was important to my parents. And once the Kennedy talked about going to the moon, I mean, we all got out of school to watch every launch on TV, and we all knew exactly what each launch was doing.
Every young kid is fascinated by space. Every child I've ever known, every child's bedroom I've ever been in has stars on the ceiling, or books about astronomy, or the moon. Kids love this stuff. They're fascinated by this stuff. And then they reach a certain age, and they just leave it behind.
Not Jawas, partir dels 8 anys, que és quan comencen a triar el que volen fer, explicar-los que l'espai ens aporta molt. I utilitzar l'espai com a font d'inspiració perquè vegin que les matemàtiques, la ciència, l'enginyeria poden ser fascinants. Jo crec que una inversió que val realment la pena és ajudar els professors, els mestres d'escola, a portar l'espai a dintre de la classe.
You have to understand that if you don't make some attempts to reach out, some attempts to communicate with people who speak a different language to you, you shouldn't be surprised if they don't really understand what you're talking about.
At the end of the day, the taxpayers don't know what they are paying for. How are they gonna want to pay for that? We don't know how to sell space very well.
You know, the old saying is still true, you know, no bucks, no Buck Rogers. If you're Elon Musk and you invented PayPal, you don't need to worry about that. For all the rest of us, we've got to get the money, and the money comes from public funds, and we have to generate public interest.
Give them what they want and not what you want, in such a way that when they get it, they will get what you want at the end.
Fer arribar la passió de la gent que està en aquest món al gran públic. Ens vam enamorar una vegada i vivim ara d'aquesta relació. I deia Carl Sagan que quan un està enamorat el que vol precisament és transmetre-ho a tothom i que tothom sàpiga que està enamorat. Ell estava enamorat del món de l'espai i va fer una obra tan absolutament primordial com era Cosmos, que és un al·legat a l'amor i està fet des de l'amor i des de la passió d'alguna manera. I jo crec que aquest és el camí a seguir. O sigui, nosaltres ens arriben segurament els resultats, però no ens arriba aquest procés, no ens arriba el procés fins a arribar a. A mi aquest procés em sembla apassionant i quan he anat coneixent figures, científics, divulgadors, etc., m'han semblat històries absolutament interessants per poder explicar al gran públic.
There's a great thing going on right now, this day without space. If you turn space off for a day, then a lot of people would know. You know, the GPS wouldn't work, they couldn't use their credit cards. And space is this invisible utility. The geostationary weather satellites. This probably has had the most practical benefit of all the remote sensing, just from the major weather systems, cyclones, tornado, hurricanes. The ability to track and monitor and predict major storm events has saved an untold number of tens of thousands of lives.
El retorn és en negoci per a empreses de gran valor afegit. Empreses que agafen les dades que arriben d'un satèl·lit meteorològic o d'un satèl·lit d'observació del medi ambient, o d'un satèl·lit de navegació i posicionament i donen un servei o una solució a un problema que millora la qualitat de vida dels ciutadans.
I work a lot with the Red Cross. People see the Red Cross vest and they see us coming and we provide them with medical assistance or food. They see us, but they don't realize that we got there using GPS, and that the planning was all done by using geographic information systems, and that the mapping of the disaster response plan was all done using satellite imagery. And so, again, it's this invisible thing behind the scenes. Nobody ever comes up to me and says, oh, thank you, Landsat, thank you, GPS, for bringing my family food.
S'inverteix en espai i no s'inverteix a l'espai, s'inverteix aquí.
It's a waste of money to spend money on space. It's a much more complicated question and people don't have time to listen to complicated answers.
Wow, interesting. Can I ask you a final question?
Sure.
Why are you doing this documentary?
Because most of the problems between humans are communication. And I think
that there is a gap in the communication between space sector and the general public. Because space inspired me, and I want to share this inspiration with the rest of the people.
You really think that space programs are good, right?
I think that space is one of the few things that unifies and defines us. I think that we, humans, are in a weak moment experiencing rapid changes that looks like we can't handle. It is just my opinion, but I think that apart from the tangible benefits that we can bring back, there are a lot of intangibles. Things that you can't measure properly. Interest, questions, inspiration, motivation, dreams. Space makes us dream, makes me dream, and dreams. Dreams are dreams.
As you have seen, space brings a lot of benefits, and a lot that have not been mentioned. Benefits, tangible benefits, intangible benefits. So the question is, why space? Maybe it should be. Why not? It is true that there are many things that have to be fixed on Earth. It is true that leaving the planet without having learned how to be sustainable and use just one planet to persist is not the solution. It is true that space costs a lot of money, but it is also true that if you follow the chain, the money goes to people, to pay salaries. Maybe the salaries are too high, maybe. But remember that we invented money. Money is just money. But people will is everything. When someone has a dream, few more things are needed to make something happen. Space education and outreach is very important for both the space sector and the general public. If we want to know, we should ask and don't think that things are for granted. And if we want to explain, we should use the other one's language to understand each other. We need to stand up and face challenges. We need to continue learning about our environment, our planet, about ourselves. We need to think, we need to be, and we need to happen.
What we're doing in space is the first of its kind. We're the first ones doing each milestone. It's never been done before.
Inicialment jo de molt petit era molt trekky, mirava Star Trek, soc molt fan doncs, de la ciència-ficció i sempre penso que si això l'espai m'ho provoca a mi, m'agradaria pensar que això també ho puc provocar en el públic aquí i explico les meves històries.
You don't want to be an astronaut?
No, I was interested in astronauts, but I'm a little bit too scared to be an astronaut. I'd like to... I always like to be with my 2 feet on the ground, and that's why I ended up in the world of football, of course.
Right now, publicly, in this interview, I will volunteer to be the first person to get to go to Mars.
No, pilot, sí, astronauta, no.
When I was a kid, I didn't even know what was an astronaut. I wanted to be a witch and fly to the moon.
So one of the things we talk about a lot in Futures, and something that Jim Dator talks a lot about in his book particularly, is that there's a gap between what people believe about space, which is based mostly on movies, television, and games, and the reality of our space programs. And these two subjects are light years apart. and that the gap is made worse by the fact that real space is all about STEM and no STEAM, so there's no arts, it's all boring technical stuff and none of the exciting humanistic stuff that most people want.
If you want to reach out to different target audiences, different from the ones you would normally go to, certainly using the arts is a very powerful way.
And this question comes from Edu Imerick. Thank you for this. Addressed to all, so it's good for a conclusion question and sounds simple. Is space still your dream, Mr. Bolden?
Yes.
Thank you. Mr. Savelyev?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
我们认为是的.
Yes.
Okay, this is a perfect closing of our session. Thank you. Thanks to the gentlemen on the podium. Thank you for all your interest. Have a nice Congress, an interesting Congress, and a good evening. Thank you. Goodbye.